Merry Christmas. Today I'm going to read some Christmas stories, so I'm getting in the mood. I wore my Jingle Bell necklace, and I hope you're getting excited because Christmas is coming. A few more weeks, and we'll be there. I think it's exactly 2 weeks and one day until Christmas. Well, first I'm going to read a short, cute little poem about chipmunks at Christmas. And then second, I'll read a book, and I'll tell you the title in just a minute, okay? So first is a really cute picture. This is called A Very Small Christmas. And this is from a book called The Animals' Merry Christmas. It's a golden book, and it's a book that I had when I was young. So it was written originally in 1950. There's a collection of cute little stories about animals at Christmas. And this is the last one in the story. And maybe I'll read another in the book, I mean. And maybe I'll read another one another time. But today we're going to read this one. I wanted to show you the picture because look at all those cute little chipmunks lined up in their beds. Yep. Some are in the bed. Some are getting ready. They're just cute. All different colored robes on them too. And blankets. It says, A Very Small Christmas. I wonder if the chipmunks know when everything is white with snow and night starts coming very fast. The Christmas time is here at last. And do the little chipmunks go to sleep quite early in a row with Christmas dreams inside their heads and extra blankets on their beds? Cold. And do they hop up just at dawn? That means when the sun comes up. And do they hop up just at dawn and put their robes and slippers on and hurry out to peep and see if someone brought a Christmas tree? If someone did, I wonder who. Their chimney's small to wriggle through. Their Christmas tree must be a twig. But maybe chipmunks think it's big. I hope it's trimmed with sunflower seeds and peanuts too, and icy beads. And lighted candles, birthday size, the little ones, to make a grand chipmunk surprise. And here's this picture
of just that.
Their skinny little fireplace with their tiny little stockings. And they're so happy because look at their tree. It looks sort of like a twig. Like they said, it's small because they're small. And it's got the little peanuts and seeds and so forth, and the candles on there, and presents. They got a tricycle and a drum. And look how the here they keep coming in, and they're just so delighted with their Christmas. Isn't that cute? And that's it. It's just a cute little poem. This book is full of them, and it's just such a nice little book. Maybe I'll read you one more. This one's a little more serious. But it's called The Long Ago Donkey. One night, it seemed very cold in the big red barn. The little donkey stamped his feet. Sometimes donkeys and horses do that. I don't like winter, he said, and he pushed close to his mother. I don't like cold, snowy weather. Winter, excuse me. Either one works. Well, winter is beautiful, his mother said. Winter is best of all for donkeys because of what happened to a little donkey long ago. Here's a picture of the mommy donkey
with the baby donkey.
And a chicken in the barn, too. And there's a lantern. And they're talking. The two donkeys. And then the mother told him the story about the donkey from long ago. She told about a lonely little donkey in a cold stable on a winter night. She told of weary travelers who came to stay in the stable because all the inns in the town were full. It's like all the hotels were full. The woman was very tired, and her husband had her lie in the clean straw that was in the barn. He covered her with his mantle. That's like his cloak, like a almost like a blanket, but it's shaped more to wrap around you. Okay? And they dressed a little differently back then, and that was something he wore to keep warm. But he took it off and covered her with it to keep her warm in the barn. because the barn isn't heated and it's cold out there. The long ago donkey drew close to her to keep her warm. Do you know who that family might be? There's a man and a woman. They come to a barn on a night when there's no room in the inns or hotels. The woman's very tired, and the husband puts her in the straw with a blanket, for his coat for a blanket. There they are. Who could that be? I bet you are thinking of somebody, right? Well, toward morning, she awakened, and she gave birth to a baby boy. She wrapped the baby in soft garments. That means soft clothes. But there was no cradle in that stable. But there were mangers, and they were filled with food for the animals. And in one of these mangers, the woman carefully laid her baby. And it was just the right size. It was the long-ago donkey's own manger. It was the container that kept his hay so that he could eat. And she chose that one to put her baby in, his own manger. He drew even closer. Remember, he'd been keeping her warm. And that little donkey, and all night, he watched over the sleeping baby. Let's look at this picture. Here's the animals. They're all looking like, what is going on? And there's the baby. And there's the man, the father, and the mother. And the little donkey has gotten very close. And he's in a manger, which was his feeding trough or bin. Whatever you want to call it, it's a manger. And look out the window. Oh, there's a bright star shining up in the sky and pointing toward the baby. Right to the baby. And who's out there? If you can see really close, you can see some little white fluffy things and a man with a tall, sort of like a hook or a staff. Shepherds and their sheep, that's right. Now I'm sure you know who that was. Well, a woman stroked the little donkey's head as he stood there next to her, and then she and her husband knelt beside the manger. "We will name this child Jesus," she said. I bet you knew that. And then suddenly, the stable was filled with light from that great star that hung over it. A host of angel voices sang for joy, and the donkey put his head close to the feet of the baby Jesus. He didn't feel lonely anymore. Here's when we look at that picture. We just talked about the star, and then we see too how he's right by the feet of Jesus. Mary had been petting him, and he feels like he's in a very special place and got to see something very special. And he feels like he's in the right place. He's not lonely anymore. "And that was the first Christmas," said the mother donkey as she finished her story to the little donkey. "And this is Christmas too." The cold barn was lighted with the stars of Christmas. Now no angel sang, but there was a wonderful singing silence. Have you ever heard of a singing silence? It's hard to describe, but it's like you just have this happiness inside. And even though there's not a band playing or a piano or a guitar or someone singing, you feel like singing in your heart. And the little donkey's heart was glad because of the story his mother had told him. "I do like winter," he said drowsily. "I like Christmas, and I'm not one bit cold anymore." And the little donkey fell asleep close to his mother's warm side. And there he is, cuddling with his mama. And he was tired and ready for sleep, but after he had heard that story, wasn't cold anymore. He felt warm inside from hearing about baby Jesus and that first donkey that shared its manger with baby Jesus and kept baby warm. Yeah. And so hearing that, it made him warm and happy inside. He and his mom snuggled and had a good night's sleep. It was Christmas. Well, I read you two stories from that book, so I think I'll say goodbye, and then I'll record my other book next. Okay? So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon. Bye.